Hello everyone, this is Kunal Khudania, and today we are going to talk about the risk associated with debt funds. And welcome back to our another chapter of Debt Ke Fund Day. So I hope you are safe and doing well during these tough times. So I'm sure so far you would have learned about the basic concepts of the debt funds, and most importantly, you would have also gone through how to choose a debt fund and how to read a riskometer. So today we are going to discuss a very important topic, which is risk associated with debt funds. So whenever you invest into any asset class, be it your financial asset class or your commodity asset class, the first question which comes up into your mind is that what is the risk that I am carrying by investing into that product? When you are investing into a debt fund, the risks basically come in two forms. First one is your interest rate risk, and second one is the credit risk. So in today's discussion, we will discuss both these risks one by one in a very brief manner. So similar to how the prices keeps on changing in the equity markets, similar to that in the debt market, your interest rate keeps on moving up or down. Now, depending on the movement of the interest rate, it impacts your portfolio as well. So now you would have learned that debt in funds invest into a lot of debt instruments. So whenever the interest rate changes, it impacts the price of the instruments where the debt fund is invested. Now, how does it impact? So basically, there is an inverse correlation between the interest rate and the price of the instrument. That means when the interest rate moves up, the price of the bond comes down, or price of the instrument comes down. And when the interest rate moves down, the price of the instrument goes up. To better understand it, let's take an example. So let's say you have bought an instrument for 100 rupees and you are getting 10 rupees as interest on that instrument. So your current earning rate of interest is at 10%, right? Now, let's assume the price of that security which you bought for 100 rupees moves up to 110 rupees. And again, you are earning the same 10 rupees on that 110. So your effective rate of interest that you are earning is now 9%. And similarly, if we assume that the price of the security moves down to 90 rupees from 100 rupees, and again, if you are earning the same 10 rupees, then your interest earning is around 11%. So that is how basically the interest rate movements impact the price of the securities and ultimately your investment portfolio. Now, secondly, the impact also depends upon the duration of the fund. So higher the duration of the fund is, higher the impact, and lower the duration of the fund is, lower would be the impact. So duration is nothing but like kind of an average maturity of the portfolio, that when all the instruments which are invested in that debt fund is maturing. So by managing the duration of the portfolio, generally the interest rate volatility is being driven through. So let's take an example of a short-term fund. So you would know that short-term fund has an investment horizon of 1 to 3 years. So whenever the market outlook suggests that the interest rate is going to move up, that is when there could be negative impact on the portfolio, the fund duration is brought down. So in our case, for a short duration fund, if the interest rate outlook suggests that the interest rate will move up, then the fund duration might be brought down to closer to 1 year. And similarly, if the market outlook suggests that the interest rates can go down from the current levels, then obviously the fund duration will again be increased to closer to 3 years. So this is how, by managing the duration of the portfolio, you generally tide out the interest rate risk. Now, the most important factor which one should watch out for before investing into a debt fund is your credit risk. So when a debt fund invests into a particular instrument, there are two earning opportunities in that. One is obviously the regular interest payment, and second one is the final principal payment which the issuer has to pay at the time of maturity. So if any of these is not being paid on time, that is either the interest amount or the principal amount is not paid by the issuer on time, then that situation is termed as credit risk default or default. So credit risk is nothing but it measures the risk of default by investing into a particular instrument. Now the question comes up how an investor has to assess that risk. So basically to assess that risk, we look at the credit rating of the portfolio or the credit rating of the instruments where the portfolio has invested. Now, unlike the interest rate where there was an inverse correlation between interest rate and the price, in terms of credit rating, there is a direct relationship between credit rating and the price of instrument. So basically, if your credit rating goes down, the price of instrument also goes down, and vice versa. If the credit rating goes up, the price of instrument also goes up. So in layman terms, one can equate a credit rating to a quality of a product. So for a higher quality of product, obviously you will pay higher price, and for a lower quality of product, obviously lower price will be demanded. Credit rating is nothing but an indicator of the financial strength of the issuer. Now, who assigns the credit rating? So in India, there are a lot of different credit rating agencies who assign a credit rating to a particular issuer. Now, some of the prominent names in this space are your CRISIL, CARE, and ICRA, which assigns credit rating to different issuers. Now, in basic concepts, you would have learned that debt instruments could be classified into two broad parts, your long-term instruments and the short-term instruments. Now, long-term instruments basically are the instruments which have a maturity of more than 1 year, and short-term instruments are the instruments where the maturity is of up to 1 year. So similarly, the credit rating agencies have different scale for long-term instruments as well as the short-term instruments. So as you can see in this slide on the left-hand side, the long-term rating scale basically starts from AAA, which is the highest safety, and ends at D, which is the default risk. So as you can see, as you move down the curve from AAA to AA, the degree of safety reduces and the risk of default increases. Now, in long-term rating, for categories from AA till C, there is a plus or minus symbol also attached to it. So plus is slightly a higher degree of safety and minus is slightly a lower degree of safety. So your overall long-term credit rating scale moves like AAA, then you have AA plus, AA, AA minus, A plus, A minus, so on and so forth, with D with the default category. Similarly, on the short-term rating, the rating scale starts from A1 and ends at B, which is the default category. So like in long-term rating, you had a plus or minus symbol attached to it. In short-term rating, you only have a plus symbol attached to it or no symbol attached to it. So in short-term rating, your highest rating starts at A1 plus, then you have A1, then you have A2 plus, and then you have A2. So on and so forth. So by looking at the credit rating of the overall debt fund portfolio, as well as the credit rating of the instruments where the fund has invested, one can form an opinion on what kind of credit risk the portfolio carries or what is the degree of safety you generally have by investing in that portfolio. So we have discussed both these risks separately. Now let's look at both these risks together. So what we do generally feel is that interest rate risk is very much temporary in nature and credit risk is permanent in nature. So you will see somewhere around in year 2017, the 10-year G-Sec rate was somewhere around 6.5%. Then again in 18-19, it moved up above 8%. Then again in 19-20, it is back to your 6.5%. So this basically shows nothing, but it demonstrates that the interest rates are pretty much in cyclical in nature. It keeps on moving up and down, but generally in the fixed income markets, the interest rate cycle takes a complete 3 to 5 years of duration to complete itself. And that is the time when the complete cycle completed, right? So when you are investing into a debt fund, interest rate risk is very much temporary, Because if you are staying invested for a complete horizon of that fund, then interest rate risk is something which is basically taken care of by the duration management. And also, when you complete the whole cycle, your interest rate volatility doesn't matter. Now, if we talk about the credit risk is very permanent in nature. That means if the credit risk materializes, then there is no recovery to it. Even if the recovery happens, it takes a lot of time. And also, it will not guarantee you 100% recovery. In most of the cases, it could be somewhere between 50% or somewhere around that. So that's how we call as interest rate risk is temporary. And you basically stick to the core fundamentals of debt investing. That is something which could be taken care of. But credit risk is something which can't be compensated back, and it is very much permanent in nature. So when you are making any investment decision to invest into a debt product, obviously interest rate risk is a factor, but credit risk should be a key factor to watch out for. So that's all from our side for today. Thank you and take care.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.